So with the help of this graph, we understood that how the voltage and current, that difference between voltage and current, that phase difference gives a zero power consumption in a complete cycle for a capacitor. One important thing here, it is voltage, and for a capacitor we know Q is equal to CV. So we can say that Q is proportional to voltage. So here we can see when the voltage increases, the charge on the capacitor also increases. When this voltage decreases, or voltage increases on the other side, this charge on the capacitor increases on other side. So let us understand in terms of charge and discharge. One important thing, this is voltage increase, so charge is increasing. So this is called charge increase, is called charging of capacitor, charging. When this voltage decreases to zero, this is called discharging of the capacitor. This is discharging. Now voltage reverses and voltage starts increasing on the other side, reverse side. So capacitor starts charging but on the opposite side. Again, this is charging, this is not discharging, because this has only changed the side, but the property is charging. Then again voltage starts dropping to zero, the capacitor starts discharging. Capacitor starts discharging. So what we have learned? So one time this side could be positive, this side is negative. So adding charges on these sides are called charging. If this charge is removed, this is called discharge. Again, if capacitor, these sides are reversed, this is positive, this is negative, this is still called charging of the capacitor, then removing these charge are called discharging. So discharging is when charge becomes zero. So this is charge becoming zero. Discharging is not that it is going in the reverse direction. It is still charging, but in reverse direction. Discharging is this, going back to zero. Now let us understand it from capacitor's perspective. So in case of capacitor, we have started at this point zero. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. First capacitor charges. So here we see that capacitor is charging. So this is charge. Then capacitor discharges. That means charge is again going back to zero. So this is on the other side, but capacitor is charging. Then capacitor discharges. So charge, discharge, charge and discharge. So in case of capacitor, we have started with maximum current and zero voltage. At point 1, voltage is maximum, current is zero. At point 2, current is maximum in other direction, but voltage is zero. Now let us understand with the help of these diagrams. So current is positive at zero point and voltage is zero. Voltage is increasing, current is decreasing. So from this 0 to 1, the current flows as shown, and from maximum at 0. So current is maximum at this 0 and reaches 0 at value 1. So at 1, this current is becoming 0. So current is from maximum to this 0.1 is becoming 0. So current is flowing clockwise. So here you see this is positive charge, this is negative charge. So current is flowing in this direction clockwise. The plate A is charged to positive polarity. In this case, what is happening? A is charged with positive polarity while the negative charge build up at Q. Now this reaches at maximum at 1. Why it is reaches at maximum 1? Because at 1 point V is maximum, and we have already seen Q is proportional to V, not I. Though current is decreasing, but voltage is increasing and charge on the capacitor is proportional to voltage. So voltage is increasing, voltage reaches at its maximum at point 1. So at point 1, charge is also at its maximum. So charge Q builds up on these plates and reaches at maximum at 1. Until the current becomes 0. So now current has started becoming 0. Now voltage is Q by C. This we have already seen. Q is equal to CV and V is equal to Q by C. This we have already seen. An important thing, the voltage VC is in phase with the charge and both reaches maximum value at this point 1. Both are reaching at maximum. Maximum voltage, maximum charge accumulated on the plates of the capacitor. Current and voltage both are positive. So here in this first quadrant, first part. So what we see in first part 0 to 1, both are positive. Voltage is increasing, current is decreasing, but both are in the positive. So power consumed is positive. So power consumed positive means energy is absorbed from the source during this quarter of the cycle and capacitor becomes charged. So power is consumed, capacitor becomes charged because even though voltage started from zero and capacitor and current decreased to zero, but both were in positive, hence power is consumed. Now let us see what happens from 1 to 2. This 1 to 2, what is happening at this place? From 1 to 2, the current I is reversing its direction. So current I is reversing its direction. So again it is increasing, but in the reverse direction. It is not going to be zero, it is increasing. The accumulated charge is depleted. So now what happens? This charge starts slowly coming down. So current is reversed, this charge is slowly starts depleting. The capacitor is discharged during the second quarter. So here what we have seen, so voltage is coming down, capacitor is also discharging. The voltage gets reduced but still positive. So what we have seen, even in this quarter, voltage is still positive but current is negative. The current is negative, voltage positive. Their product, that means power is negative in this from 1 to 2 second quarter. Hence the energy absorbed during first cycle, here energy is absorbed. This energy absorbed in the first quarter of cycle is returned to the system by the capacitor. So here since power is negative, that means energy that was stored in the capacitor in form of charge, that is returned back to the system. Now let us come to this third part from 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. So let us see, this is third part. So in third part, 2 to 3, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. As I continues to flow from A to B. So I is flowing, so this current has started coming down in the reverse direction, but it's starting coming down. As I continues to flow from A to B, the capacitor is charged to reverse polarity. Now what we see, voltage is increasing, capacitor is charging but in reverse direction. So here previously A was positive, B was negative, but here what we see, A is now negative, B is positive. Now capacitor is charging but in reverse direction. The plate B acquires positive charge and A acquires negative charge. Both current and voltage are negative in this quarter. So here we see both are in negative. Their product P is positive. Since both are negative, product P is positive. Hence the capacitor absorbs energy in this 1/4 of cycle. Both are negative, energy is absorbed. Now let us see the fourth quarter from 3 to 4. Now current I is now reverse its direction. Current has reversed its direction. The current I reverses its direction at 3 and flows from B to A. So now current is flowing in the reverse direction. The accumulated charge is depleted and magnitude of voltage VC is reduced to VC becomes 0. So here what we see, this VC is becoming 0. This VC becomes 0, that means charge is also reduced, charge is being depleted. At 4, when the capacitor is fully discharged, at this point 4, capacitor becomes fully discharged. The power is negative because this current is positive, voltage is negative. So power is negative, energy absorbed during this cycle returned back to the source. Hence we have seen first cycle power absorbed, second cycle power returned, power absorbed, then power returned. So total power consumed in a complete cycle is 0.